Welcome to 10 Minute IELTS. Today, we'll be learning how to speak in a British accent. Now, this is not necessarily something I want you to do, but it is something I'd like you to learn, especially for the listening test. I believe that the listening test can be especially difficult if you are not accustomed to the British accent. In fact, the British accent is a lot rarer to hear than the American accent, which will not be the case in the listening test. So it would be a good idea to understand how the Brits talk or their manner of speaking, but again, this is not necessary for speaking. In fact, you may get deductions in speaking for an inappropriate tone or wrong diction if the accent is too thick. Take note that accent does not mean proper pronunciation. So the best really is to speak in an accent or in a manner that can be clearly understood by the examiner. But now again, moving on to learn how the British accent and listening tests work, there are five main rules. The first being there are no T sounds after vowel sounds. What do I mean? Just with the word British, there is no need to accentuate the T sound. In fact, you may not hear any T at all. Instead, what you may hear is British. Repeat that after me. British. Do not say British. British. Another word that may commonly have the T sound for most, but not in the British accent, is the country Britain. Don't say Britain. You could instead say Britain. This also applies to other words such as little, which becomes little, and kettle, which would become kettle. To best practice this, let's see how you'll be able to apply the British accent in this sentence. I went to Britain and learned that British brew leaves or little leaves in a kettle. Now, that is how most Americans would pronounce this sentence, but instead of pronouncing the T's, let's omit them and say, I went to Britain and learned that British brew little leaves in a kettle. That way, we are not pronouncing the T anymore. One more time, I went to Britain and learned that British brew little leaves in a kettle. Keep practicing that because it's important to understand this rule as we move on to the second one, which is that there are no R sounds after vowel sounds in the British accent. For example, when we use the word car, we do not need to pronounce the R anymore because most Brits would use an H word instead by saying ka. So don't say car if you want to use the British accent. You would probably hear in the listening test ka instead, as well as park, which would be pronounced as park. And when you combine those two, car park could become ka park. Now remember that this is something that we have to accentuate. Do not make it quick like the Chinese would, which is kapak. I park my car in the kapak. Again, that is not the British accent that you will hear in the listening test. Instead, you might hear, I learned how to park my car in the car park. Let's try that. I learned how to park my car in the car park. Of course, this is completely different from the proper way to pronounce the R, which is I learned to park my car in the car park, which is why I would again accentuate that this is something that I just want you to understand, but not necessarily use all the time. The third rule is that ER sounds become AH sounds. What do I mean? When you see words ending in ER, such as mother, and will be instead pronounced as mother, and sister could become sister. Now you may hear this pronunciation from time to time and wonder why it's pronounced as AH, and that's again because Brits would pronounce ER as AH most of the time. So let's cancel these previous parts so I have space and try using the British accent in this sentence. My mother and sister are better at cooking than me and my brother. But instead, make the ER sounds AH and say my mother. Ready? And my mother and sister are better at cooking than me and my brother. So brother instead of brother and mother instead of mother. Next, the fourth rule is all the Y and LY sounds at the end of words become EH and LEH. What do I mean? One adjective that most Brits like to use is lovely, but they would not say, oh, how lovely. They would say, how lovely, as in L-E-H, lovely. So lady would also become lady, and party would not be pronounced with the R sound, as I mentioned before. Instead, it would be pronounced as party. So let's try that in this next sentence. I met a lovely lady at a newlywed party. Now that's the American way, or most likely the neutral way of pronouncing it. But if you want to make your accent more British, let's end L-Y and Y in E-H and say, I met a lovely lady at a newlywed party. Again, I met a lovely lady at a newlywed party. And you'll notice that it sounds a bit more sophisticated, but again, this is not necessarily the correct way of pronouncing the word. It is simply an accent. The last one is to exaggerate the O sounds. What do I mean by this? You may pronounce don't as simply don't, but what I want you to do when you pronounce don't is to emphasize the O by having O-shaped lips. So have the letter O shape of your lips and say don't, don't. The same applies when you are saying the word hot. Now, Americans may say, oh my God, it's so hot in here. But it's not hot in British, it's hot, hot with the O-shaped lips. Let's try that in this sentence. I don't like piping hot coffee. And again, exaggerate the O. I don't like piping hot coffee. This is a Y sound at the end, and instead of coffee, coffee. Ready, set? I don't like piping hot coffee. And tone down the heat of the stove. Now notice that this is not necessarily how all Brits talk, but it is dependent on the thickness of the accent. You may hear, I don't like piping hot coffee, tone down the heat of the stove, or I don't like piping hot coffee, tone down the heat of the stove. And again, that would be simply a level of thickness. How thick is the accent of the British national? Remember those five rules if you want to understand the British accent. Again, the first is there is no T. Second is there is no R. The third is that ER becomes AH. And the fourth is that Y or L-I-Y becomes EH and L-E-H. Whereas the last one is that the O becomes exaggerated. For this last sentence, let's see if you can pronounce Harry, please open a bottle of wine. I hope it doesn't taste or it won't taste bitter. Ready, set? This will be Harry, please open a bottle of wine. I hope it won't taste bitter. Bitter. Ready? One last time. Harry, please open a bottle of wine. I hope it won't taste bitter. And there you have it, the British accent. I hope that this will be useful in your listening test. Remember to like, share, and subscribe. And if you want, click on the description below for online coaching. Thank you and good luck with your review.